There are many things that we can thank the Muslim world for, and in this episode of FCD Facts, I'm looking at 10 surprising Muslim discoveries and inventions that we still use today. So welcome back, guys. My name is Leroy Kenton, and we're gonna just hop right into everything. We got number 10 first. Hospitals. So the first modern hospital with nurses and training center and everything was in Cairo. The Ahmed Ibn Tulun Hospital was established in the year 872. All patients received free healthcare, which was a Muslim tradition that was institutionalized when the hospitals started to become a thing. Now this model would later serve as a template for other hospitals that would appear in different parts of the world. And number 9 is the toothbrush. So Islam places a lot of emphasis on hygiene, and the ancient Egyptians are thought to have chewed on twigs from what's called a toothbrush tree. However, these twigs, also known as miswaka, became known to a lot more people when the Prophet Muhammad started using them regularly to brush his teeth. The Quran does not mention miswak twigs specifically, however, many Islamic scholars have mentioned it in their writings. Number 8 brings us magnifying glass as well as glasses. It's grouped together and you'll see why. The scholar Hassan ibn al-Haytham from Basra, Iraq, was the first person to describe how the eye actually works. He carried out some experiments with reflective materials and proved that our eyes don't actually emit rays to perceive our environment as it was believed up until then. He also discovered that curved glass surfaces can actually be used for magnification. His glass reading stones were the first magnifying glasses that were ever created, and it was from these that glasses were later developed. So people started wearing them on their face to now see better, increase magnification, and of course that led to telescopes and binoculars, so many other things. An amazing one is also the camera. So Hassan ibn al-Haytham appears again for his revolutionization of optics. So he completely rejected the Greek idea that invisible light rays emitted from our eyes and that caused sight, and he believed that vision was caused by light reflecting off an object and entering our eye. In a genius experiment using a dark room with a pinhole on one side and a white sheet on the other side, he proved this theory. Light came through the pinhole and it projected an inverted image of objects that were outside of the room onto the sheet on the opposite side. He called this the Camara, and it was the world's first camera obscura, which we get the term camera from. Clocks come in at number 6. So there was an ingenious man called Al-Jazari from Turkey, and he was a very devout Muslim as well as a highly skilled engineer, and he created the concept of automatic machines. By the year 1206, Al-Jazari had made numerous clocks of all shapes and sizes. So of course, as we need time today to stay on schedule, structure our lives, so did Muslims over 700 years ago. They knew that it was important to know the time so that they can do things like their regular prayers and things like that. So this, of course, was a revolutionary invention. At number 5, we have surgical instruments. So back in the 10th century, the surgeon Abul Qasim Khalif al-Abad al-Zawahri, he was a man known in the West as Abul Qasis, and he wrote the Al-Tadrif, his medical encyclopedia, which included a section called On Surgery. And this had a large collection of over 200 surgical tools. Using instruments for surgery was a very revolutionary concept because it actually enabled science to change from just being a speculative theory to something that can be experimental now. His work was the first in history of the medicine to illustrate the use of surgical instruments. And the design have only changed a little bit in 1,000 years. So it were these illustrations that would lay the foundations for surgery in Europe and in other parts of the world. The fourth spot brings us flying machines. So Abbas ibn Firnas, he was the first person to make a real attempt to construct a flying machine and actually fly. In the 9th century, he designed a winged device that looked like a bird costume. And in a trial run that he did in Spain, Firnas flew upward for a few moments before falling right down and breaking his back. His design would be an inspiration for future flying devices and vehicles. At number three brings us coffee. So coffee, to a large degree, is the best known of the Muslim world's exports. While it originated in Ethiopia, it soon found its way over to the Red Sea, to the Arabian Peninsula, where it grew in popularity. The legend tells us of an Arab goat herder who noticed their change in mood when the goats ate a certain berry. So he boiled the berries and came up with the first coffee. So yeah, coffee, a very interesting origin story. I know there are some conflicting origin stories out there, but let me know what you think down below. Yeah, Muslim invention or not? This one is probably the one I was a little bit about, but sources do indicate that this was a Muslim invention. Algebra is at number two. So the word algebra comes from the title of a Persian mathematician and his famous work in the 9th century. And that was called the Kitab al-Jabr wal-i-Mugabala. Muhammad ibn Musa Khwarizmi introduced the beginnings of algebra, and it was a revolutionary move away from the Greek concept of mathematics, which was for the most part based on geometry. He also was the first person to introduce a concept of raising a number to a power. And in number one, we have the modern standing army. So the first modern standing army was developed by the Ottoman Empire. While technically speaking, you know, a slave army in the early days in Europe was thought to be the first standing army, but of course other standing armies did exist as well in the past, like the Romans and the Spartan armies, for example. However, unlike other armies before them, the Janissary soldiers were actually paid a regular income, and they were, however, forbidden to marry and engage in any type of trade. They would later become famed and known for their internal cohesion, their strict discipline, as well as their fighting skills. By the 17th century, their power would grow so much to a level that they were able to become what's called kingmakers in the Ottoman Empire, and then they were later disbanded. Okay guys, so those were 10 surprising Muslim discoveries and inventions. I know that was a super exciting one. Sound off in the comments section down below about anything that I mentioned in this episode, and also let me know what future FTD Facts videos you would like to see next. Well, if you want to check out another video like this, you gotta just tap the annotation right beside my head right here. And don't forget to follow me on social media. Those links are below in the video description as well. And while you're at that, hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you'll be notified of future videos here on FTD Facts.